Hey everyone, Skorch A2 here. Just wanted to do something special for you guys real quick. I've got an unboxing that I'm going to do here for a computer part that I went and picked up at Newegg. And I'm just going to go ahead and cut the tape on this thing. So it's actually something that needs a little bit of installation, so what I'm probably going to try to do is open this thing up here and then see if I can do the installation as well. So it'll depend on what it is that I've actually got to do to this thing. So what I've got here is a couple things. One of them is some thermal compound remover and some surface purifier. We're gonna do a little bit of work with that. Packing slip, envelope, bunch of peanuts. So what have we got here? We have this thing called the Accelero Twin Turbo 6990. It's a, let's see if I can make sure you can see it here. It's a cooling unit for an AMD Radeon HD 6990 video card. That's the model of video card that I actually have in my computer. And one thing that I tend to notice, and I've read some reviews on certain forums and stories told about similar experiences with this particular card. It's a twin GPU video card that actually runs quite a bit hotter than most of the ones that I've had in the past. And I've noticed that when I play certain games, it gets pretty busy. It's kind of loud, and it runs quite a bit hotter than I think it should. So I bought this thing. I've heard really good reviews on its ability to cut down on the noise dramatically, and they have it run probably 20 degrees cooler on average than it normally would. So I'm going to go ahead and pull apart my computer, get my video card out, and we're going to see if I can run an installation on that thing on the video. So we'll see how it turns out, and I'll be back with you guys in a bit. Alright, so we got everything out here, and so I've got myself my toolkit. Here's my video card. This is the side, the view from the back or the top, depending on how you look at it when you install it. This is actually the side that faces up. So you can see here the back of the two GPU cores. And if you flip it over, you can see that the labeling has actually started to come off of this thing because of the heat that it's generated and because the adhesive is not very good. So I pulled some of it off of there. But you can see this thing is pretty massive. It takes quite a bit of power. So what we got to do is we got to take the PCB off the back. So there's a bunch of screws we got to take off on all of these. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And what I'll probably do here, let's go ahead and put this down real quick. I'll show off some of this stuff, and then I'll kind of zoom in so you might get a better look at some of this stuff. But here's what was actually in the box. So this thing, you can tell, is actually quite a bit. It's pretty big. It's a little bit bigger than the card itself. But you got two fans on here, a bunch of heatsink material. This is the part that'll actually mount to the circuit board. And then we got a bunch of copper piping. It's supposed to be really good for heat dissipation. And it's got, it came with a little bit of Arctic Silver thermal compound, it looks like. Yep. So this stuff right here, I swear by this. I'm gonna use what they gave me because it's already here. I've got a tube of it myself that I use for mounting processors and whatnot, but I don't want to go dig it out since they gave it to me. That's nice. Then we have some thermal padding here. This is going to go on some of the contacts that are inside the casing. I've got instructions to follow, so bear with me while I go ahead and get that set up. Alright, so it's kind of in the center here. Move everything out of the way. I'm going to go ahead and start taking this stuff off. I got some paper towels and everything ready for when we have to actually take the stuff, the thermal compound off. Let's go ahead and start here. Okay, that should be the last one here. I'm gonna speed up tedious parts. Now I gotta figure out how to get this thing off of here. There we go. That was a little quick. So you can see here's the thermal compound that we're going to have to clean off of these contacts. So that's what I got the tissue for. Paper towel, rather. Let's open this bag. This should actually come out of the casing here. To grab the contacts. All right. Now there's a small electrical connection right down here in the corner. Fragile little thing. All right, so PCB of a video card. So that gotta make sure I can still is still in vision here. I was probably doing a lot of that stuff where you weren't able to see it, but that's what that thing looks like. So there's the two cores, and I gotta clean these off. Here's some stuff that kind of remained on here. It looks like most of it remained on the heat sink itself, on the cooler. So I'm gonna go ahead and set that over there because I don't need that anymore. Go ahead and pull this over here. Make sure I'm still good. What happens when you're a one-man camera operation? So I'm going to go ahead and get the thermal remover. Just go ahead and start wiping. Bit of a tough job with only two hands, but should be good to go. Alright, so basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to keep wiping these contacts here. So there's one there, there's a couple here, there's two here, the other core on this side. I'm going to go ahead and get those cleaned off, and then when I come back in, we'll be ready to apply the new compound and the padding. And we should be ready to assemble. Alright, so I'm finishing up the last bit of clean off here. Actually, I'm seeing some dust in this thing because it pulls in the dust from the intake and it gets stuck in here. That's one thing that's hard about these internal parts, is it's really hard to keep them clean. So now, should be able to... Let's see, I think I gotta prepare this now. Basically, on the back of this thing, we've got these contacts that I may or may not have showed earlier in the video. So there's the two parts that attach to the cores, and then the padding's going to go on these sections right here. So I'm going to go ahead and there's some film on the back that I've got to take off. What I've got to finish first here is I've got to finish preparing these and put the compound on. So this is just a purifier to make sure it gets all the stuff that would make the thermal bond less effective off of there. Think of it like disinfecting a wound. Kind of like that. Alright, so we're all prepared and ready to go. So now what I'm going to go ahead and do is start getting this thing prepared. Go ahead and put the cap back on that. Move the board on top of that box. And I'm going to go ahead and get this all set up. Alright, so now what I've got to do is I've got to get the padding out of here. So I'm going to go ahead and take these out. There's some spacers there in case I need them. Last one being a pain in the ass. It's like stuck to the bottom of the bag. There we go. Come on out. I don't even need to keep it. So this big one here goes on this square piece. There's another film layer on here that I'll have to remove. Maybe not, though. Looks like that's it. These long strips go on the ones on the end here. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and finish attaching the rest of these, and then when I come back, I'll do final assembly. Okay, so now we've got all the thermal compound and the padding applied, so this thing has to go back on. The way that works is the end that's flush with the heat sink and the fan, that's the end that's got the exhaust outlet on it. So I'm going to go ahead and get this thing lined up. Basically, you just do it with the screw holes, like so. Oops, there was actually one thing I should have done. It's not too difficult. So there's that plug that I mentioned in the back here that's gotta be plugged in. I'm gonna go ahead and get that plugged in. Then what I'm gonna go ahead and do is start getting the stuff ready to go, and we'll get the screws put back on and she'll be good to go. I'll be back. All right, so I'm back, and I got all the screws put back in here. So if you take a look, you can see that I had to get all the trying to align this thing right so you guys can see it. I'm looking at the back of the camera while I'm doing this. Okay, so I got everything all lined back up again. I got the mounting brackets back in. I got the mounting screws back in. Everything attached to the heatsink. The electrical connection has been made down here. You can barely see that right there. So I turned this thing over, and that's what we got. So we got our big Hurricane fans. We got our cooling unit. And the mounting plate mounted back on the back, and we are ready to pop this sucker back in. So, sorry about the spotty camera work. It's hard to do this with a one-man show, and I'm actually using my digital camera to do this. So, I kind of wanted to give my shot at doing some videos like this. So, if you guys could let me know, give me your feedback. Let me know if you'd like to see more things like this. I'll go ahead and see about getting something a little more suited for off the computer type video. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and sign off now. And if you guys see me back on anytime soon, you can probably assume this thing worked. So with that, I bid you good night, and I will see you later. Stay tuned for the next video.